Hello everyone, and welcome back to Dawn of War 2 Retribution with the Tyranids. And having one less mission, because the Mad Mech one, the Space Hulk, didn't show up. Showed up for both the Orcs and the Chaos. Well, basically, there was a Mad Orc Mech boy who has a bunch of Kerogans and wait, no, after it. Not Kerogans. On the board, the Judgment Carrion, and it's a thing. But instead, we just went straight to quarantine mode and got access to the Swarm Lord, which is pretty freaking great, honestly.
Enlightened, ambitious.
There you go. We should probably go stop him. Honestly, we're just fine with the squad, so yeah. This is the final mission. You sure you want to do this?
Yeah, I'm sure I want to do this.
But though, is it so long of a final mission? Because I have to go from point A to point B to point C to point D to point E to point F. Just before I make it to the final section. Now we gotta watch this again. As he goes in and walks into a lava pool. Cause you know, that's fine. And Mutris is a demon prince. Over. He didn't even get become a demon prince.
I am no stranger to the deaths of planets. Cyrene was my home. Yet when the need was made evident, I did not hesitate to contact the Inquisition. By my hand, Cyrene burned. Cyrene's secrets now live solely with me, and so shall they die with me. Whether I'm victorious or slain, my sins will know retribution. Such is the final testimony of Gabriel Angelos,
I like how he's
captain of the Blood
the
Ravens, Third Company. Savior of Tartarus, bane of the Black Legion.
This is about the Tyranids.
Servant of the Emperor.
Like, this is entirely about the Tyranids.
Additional resources
about
required.
The
Tyranids.
Okay. Letter, you go. Go.
Many decades have been an honor, Gabriel. Commend my service to the Emperor.
Bye, whoever you are.
Emperor, keep you, librarian. I go now to redeem our chapter. Such are the ways of demons, to lie and mislead us. Destroying it is the only way to avoid its influences.
I mean... But what if? What if he's just, you know... just a corpse attached to the Golden Throne? Just being kept... kill much about it.
Yeah.
dreadnoughts. Cannot fold.
You can have another bunch of those.
I don't know, I wouldn't mind. Actually, you know what, sure, you guys, I should get this one board. It's highly expensive. Well, it's cheaper in population than the contracts. Well, I need population cap, population cap, population cap. I need all the population.
They think to harm me, so long as my towers of offerings are in place, I am unbeatable. Warriors, protect me offerings. My ascension is not yet complete.
So I need to remember to use my bill. Ah, well, it doesn't matter until I get up to the last fight anyway.
Okay, destroy the second tower.
Tyranids aren't the fastest army. They're also very expensive. But yeah, they barriers to keep themselves healed. He has no defense if he gets attacked.
All the blood ravens!
I need peace.
the smoosh.
By the way, we're supposed to go to the MCs. I'm pretty sure. Playing that. That means we have 5490. That means we should probably go down. Can I build it? But we can build it once we get that too. So let's just work our way down to the hive and grab that swarm. A swarm load would be nice to have. And then I'm not going to have to dash some warriors. And I would see them. Oh, well, that's good. Okay, get me a swarm lord and if possible another Z. To go grab that. No, I'm pretty sure I don't really need it. Yeah, you know. What hopes do I really need? maybe if I can afford two warriors. I don't think I can. But I see you trying to garrison inside that tower. You think that's really gonna save you? You know how much damage I could just do with just the Hive Lord? Like, I'm pretty sure he could just walk up and solo all. Get that, that's a plus and over 10? Like 15. Right? Yeah. Oh, yeah. problem is, how do I get rid of my lair? I don't really know, because... Yeah. Because the thing is that it's going to take two. And he might be able to solo these fuckers. I don't know. Normally I just, you know, keep them, but that's sort of one I've ever had. Okay, well, that's all. Jeez, you guys are fast with that swarm orb, so that's it. I was gonna say that you were such... They were very slow, but the swarm lord actually makes them a lot faster. Okay, claim the last one. Not sure who's gonna hold this line. Am I even very concerned about that line? Ah, that didn't actually increase my cap. Well, of course, glad I got rid of the letter then. The proper final arm. Because we have our high blood, right? Of 2-0. Smart man spamming that on the boss. We have our two gene stones, because gene stones are amazing. That's great, right? The two warriors do even more damage with their venom cannons. Darn it. It would be fine. I like this army. If there's a proper swarm. I would prefer, you know, 10,000 more units, but... For tactical purposes, this is a good idea. So yeah, let's go to Kairos. If they warp me down. Fire breath, oh no. Not the fire breath.
come back to that.
Do we get for a Tyranid ending? Well, we're getting a war gear this time. You know the last time we did the orcs? It's like, here's some of the best war gear obtained during the last mission. Like, I can't do anything with that. Especially not after the last mission.
Report 893880 of this lunar cycle. The final transmissions from subsector Aurelia, filed 43.6 years ago. By order of the Holy Inquisition, subsector sentenced to exterminatus. Hive fleet emerges from all sides. Exterminatus fleet driven away. Defense attempted, but Imperial forces already crippled. Imperial guard losses reached 94% before forces withdrew. Surviving loyal Blood Ravens losses, total. They refuse to retreat.
Still better than the frickin' chaos. Chaos ending was stupid. Just, okay, so we showed up, and then we left. Yeah. By the way, that was Tyranids. Gotta say, Tyranids definitely fun. And yeah, the Hive Fleet shows up. And, you know. So he brought the ships into exterminate the planets. Not really to fight against another entire fleet. So yeah, it's like, let's just get out of there. Leave it to the Tyranids. And of course, the Blood Ravens die because of the Blood Ravens. Yeah. Because Space Marines arms that are the smartest when loyalty is driven into play. But anyway. So yeah, that was Dawn of War 2 Retribution. That's 3 playthroughs. I think I'm done now. I think I was done after the Orc one, but I thought I'd give Tyranids a try. So, yeah. Okay. So, yeah. As for Dawn of War 2 Retribution. And after all this, I'd say it suffered from the fact that, well, the campaign's basically just one copy-paste of, and just we made slight changes to make it sort of work for other races, but it's basically, it's probably more focused on either the Imperial Guard or the Space Marines. Probably the Space Marines, if anything. And then you just have to toss all the other races in and slightly change things so it makes sense. Like, I'm not sure exactly how the Eldar fighting Eldar makes sense, but shrug. But yeah. Tyranids, though. Tyranids were technically there in Dawn of War 2, the first one. Less so in Dawn of War 2 Chaos Rising. I should have did those, but yeah. You don't have to deal with the hassle of re-downloading them, or dealing with Steam, or any of that nonsense. So yeah. And besides, this lets us play as Alpha Ones besides just Space Marines, cause fucking Space Marines. I could tolerate them at best, but yeah. Anyway, as for now, yeah, not much else to say. It's just, I don't know which this was changed depending on your respective race, like it is in the rank of Dawn of Wars. Like, oh, you're playing as Chaos. Well, here's a Chaos Lord. Oh, you're playing as Orcs. Well, here's an Orc Warlord. Instead of just the Inquisitor constantly. Anyway, yeah. I'm not entirely sure what's next on the agenda. Depends when things get uploaded. There's so much to upload. But yeah, that's for now. Hope you all enjoyed. Thank you all. Have a nice day.